Hello everyone. Today we are going to solve the question Valentine's sum from the day 20 of 30 days of code by GFG. So here is the question. Cupid wants to strike maximum houses in Geekland on Valentine's Day. The houses in Geekland are arranged in the form of binary tree. Cupid is standing at target node initially. Find the sum of all the nodes within a maximum distance k from the target node. The target node should be included in the sum. Okay. So for example, here we are given the target node as 9. And we are given k is 1. Okay, so we have to find the sum of the nodes up to distance 1. So here the distance is 0, so we will include this node. Okay, 9. Then here the distance is 1. 5, at 5 distance is 1. At 7 distance is 1. And at 1 distance is 1. So we will include these nodes 1, 9, 5, and 7. 1, 9, 5, and 7. Okay. Now when we look at the example 2. Here we are given the target as 40 and we are given k is equal to 2. So we have to find the sum of the nodes up to distance 2. Here we will include 40 as distance is 0. Then 19, 50, 19 and 50 as distance is 1. Then 4 as distance is 2. So here, and then we will, and then the answer will be our, the sum of these 4 values. Okay. So now let's look at the logic part. Let's look at this example. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7 and target is at 2 and k is 1. Okay, our target node is 2. So the what will be our answer? This 2 will be included as it is at the distance 0. 1, 4 and 5 are at the distance 1. So they also will be included. So what will be our answer? The answer will be the sum of 1, 2, 4 and 5. Okay. So when I saw the distance, when I saw the concept of distance, okay, that is our k is equal to 1, the first thought that came to my mind is BFS, or DFS, you can do either of the both, okay. So if I do the BFS, I can easily find the nodes which lie below this our target node, okay, with the distance less than equals to 1. But what about the nodes which lie above our target node? What we can do? We can, as this node, we can, as this is directed downwards, we cannot go up up from 2. Okay, we can go down from 2. We cannot go up from 2. Okay. So what we can do? For this, we will have a hash map which will store the parent of each node. And then you will figure out why I am doing this. Okay, so what I am having a map. Let's call this as M for easiness. Okay, so the parent of let's start with 1. The parent of 1 is null. Okay, the parent of 1 is null. Let me write this. Okay, the parent of 1 is null. The parent of 2 is 1. And the parent of 4 is 2. Parent of 5 is 2. And the parent of 3 is 1. The parent of 6 is 7. 3. And the parent of 7 is also 3. Okay, so here we have stored the parent of each node, and it will help us to find the nodes which lie above our this target node and have the distance less than equals to k. So how can we actually, how can we find this the parent of each node? We can find this by using BFS. Okay, by using BFS we will iterate through the, we will traverse through the tree, and for each node we will store its parent in a map. Okay, so since we are given the target value which is 2, we are not given the target node, so we will run a BFS through this tree to find the target. So our target node is this 2. Now we will again run a BFS through this tree to find the sum of the values which are less sum of the values which are at the distance less than equals to 1 from the target node. Okay, so here I have a cube and I also have a set. I have named set as S. Okay, this will store the nodes which we have visited. Okay, and I also have a variable sum which is initialized to value 0 initially. And I have a variable d. D stands for distance here. Okay. Initially my distance is 0. So now I will push my target node in the queue, and then I will pop it out, and then I will push the left child, right child, and the parent of target node in the queue. So let's do it. I have pushed my target node in the queue. Now I will push this 2, I will push 2 in the set, I will increment my sum by 2. Now I will increment my distance has become 1. Now I will push the left child, right child, and the parent of this target node. Left child is 4, right child is 5, and the parent is 1, and I will push these values in the set. I have pushed 4 in the set, I have pushed 5 in the set, I have pushed 1 in the set. And now here my level, here my distance was 0, here my distance is 1. Okay, now I will push this 4 out of this loop, out of this queue. I will increment my sum by 4. My sum has become 2 plus 4 now. Now I will push the left child, right child, and the parent of 4. So left child is null, right child is null, and parent of 4 is 2. But 2 is already in the set, so we will not push it. Okay. So now we come to 5. I will pop this out. I will increment this 5 in my sum. Now I will insert my left child, right child, and the parent of 5. Left child is null, right child is null, parent is 2, but 2 is we have visited 2 earlier, so we will not visit it now. Okay, now we will come to 1. I will pop this out, increment my sum by 1. Now I will push the left child, right child, and the parent of 1. The parent of 1 is null, the left child is 2, which I have visited, the right child is 3, which I have not visited. Okay, so I will push the right child of 3, and the distance becomes 2. The distance is 2 is greater than my k. Okay, so I will terminate here, and my answer will be this sum, the sum of 2, 4, 5, and 1. So what is it? 5, 4, 9, 10, 11, 12. Thus, the answer is 12. So we can have a cross check here. 2, 4, 5, and 1. Okay. So now let's move to the code part. So here is a function which we need to complete, sum at disk k. So here we are having a function store parent root target. This will store the parent of each node, and it will return the target node. Okay, which is stored in this node star t. If my t is null, I will return 0. Which is what it means, that my target node doesn't lie in the tree. Then I am having long int sum is equals to 0, which will store the sum of all the nodes which are less than equals at which are the distance less than equals to k. Okay, now here is a BFS implementation for which I have taken a queue. I have also made a set which will store the values that are visited till now. I will push my target node in the queue. I will push my target node in the set also. Initially my level is 0. I have referred to as d here, and I have referred to as level here. Both are same thing, okay, nothing different. Then I will run this while loop until my queue is empty and my level is less than equals to k. I have a variable int size equals to q.size, and now I will run a loop through this size, okay. And this f is my the front of the queue, q.front, and I will increment my sum with this data of the front. The same I was doing here. I was incrementing my sum with the data of the front of the queue. Now, if my write of the f is possible and it is not visited yet, that is s.find f write of the front is equals to s.end, then what I will do, I will push my the write of f in my queue, and I will also push it in my set. The same thing I will do for my left child of f, and the same thing I will do for my parent of f, which is storing unordered map of f, a UMF. Okay. And now at last I will pop this node out and I will increment my level. Now have a look at the store map from a store parent function. So I am having a unordered map here. Okay. Now this is a store parent function. It will store the parent of each node. Okay. So I have run a BFS here. I have run a standard BFS implementation. Okay. I have pushed the root in the queue, and while it is not empty, I have pushed my right child, I have pushed my left child, and I have set the parent of right of p as p and the parent of left of p as p. Okay. And then I have returned the target node. Okay. I will store the link to this code in the description below. You can check it out. Okay. And if you like my video, please like it. Thank you.